Hello again. I wanted to talk to you this week about a really interesting bit of kit and how it joins up, not specifically the muscle itself, but how it relates, which is the adductor longus. And as the name suggests, the adductor longus sits on the inside of the femur here, and it joins up to the pubis. And so if we look at the traditional anatomy, we'll see that the adductor longus is coming out of the pubis. And this fellow's attacking me. But the thing about the adductor longus is that it has a little companion that goes along with it. And the companion that sits with it is the gracilis. And so gracilis is this fellow that's joining up, and it's joining up in a very interesting way. And it's joining up in a very interesting way onto the inside edge of this pubis. And when it hits the front of the pubic bone, it carries on, it seems to carry on every single time, into the opposite side of the fascia of the abdomen. So what we're looking at when we look at the dissections, every time I do a dissection, we get to this sort of layer of connective tissue that sits across the top of the abdomen and encloses all the abdominal layers, is that this adductor, as it comes up, crosses over. Now, there doesn't seem to be a constant or a consistent way in which one side crosses over. So sometimes you'll get the right side crossing over on top of the left, and sometimes you'll get the left crossing over on top of the right. But it definitely does form a crossing over join up onto the right across the front edge of this pubic bone and across the joint here, the interpubic disc. The other thing about the adductor longus and the gracilis, the two of them that join together, is the gracilis then comes down and it joins up onto this inside edge of the knee here, which is joining up with the sartorius and the semitendinosus. Sartorius again coming from this top of the pelvis here, and semitendinosus coming to the back of the ischial tuberosity to form a little structure called the pes anserinus. All right. Now I'll talk about the pes anserinus in a different video, but the interesting thing about pes anserinus is that it's joining up with these three structures of the leg that are sort of traditionally quite long muscles. But at this end, it is hitting together with a really thick bag of connective tissue that encloses and encases adductor longus. So what does this mean functionally? I hesitate to go there, because the thing about this is it could mean absolutely anything. And so therefore, to extrapolate a meaning from a single attachment of a muscle is not something that really excites me or interests me, because the thing is, you can't have individual muscle function or contraction or movement. You know, it's conjoined with lots of other things. And unless you are able to consider those other things, which anatomy does very, very poorly, then you're always going to be speculating on a model. And the thing about a model is that it's always wrong. However useful, it's never going to be correct. So if we think about the conjoinment of gracilis and semitendon adductor, my muscles are mixed up now, but we think about this conjoinment, what does it mean from a manual therapy perspective? But it means that we have to think about what's reaching across to the opposite side as far as its distribution of load. Is it going inwards? Well, yeah, there's going to be some bits where it's going to join up and go inside. It's going to affect on the inside as far as the rest of the reproductive area is concerned, but certainly as far as things like groin pain is concerned, and areas around the pubis and interpubic disc, then we need to think about adductor longus and how far up it goes. You know, there's a particular move that we do in Bowen. A lot of people end up, you know, just too far down the leg. And to get really the strong fascial connection up in here is to get right up to where that adductor longus and the gracilis join and meet each other. The interesting thing is that you don't need, from my perspective, too much in the way of overadduction to end up with this sort of hip pain, back pain, buttock pain going on, you know, sort of slight overadduction, slight pulling in, which is very, very common in a lot of people. You know, the tendency is to sort of squeeze a little bit too much or pull in a little bit too much onto the adductors, and suddenly we're ending up with, you know, lower back pain because we're, you know, it's a push me, pull you scenario that's happening. So There we go. That's an interesting structure. Adductor longus. These are quick little snippets, but get your anatomy books out and have a little look and have a feel, you know, join up and go up to where it joins up to your pubis area and have a little feel where that connection goes up to and see if there's a difference from one side to the other, because there generally is as far as the tension that we have. And if you get caught putting your hands there, blame me, that's fine. So what else do we think it might be? Where else are we going to go? I would link this up to things like the diaphragm. You know, I'd bring the diaphragm down into it. But there's lots of things we could go into from there. So what do you think? Let me know. Chuck your questions down into the comment section. Share, like, do the things we're supposed to do. Please subscribe. That's a really important one for us as far as getting our numbers on YouTube is concerned. So thanks very much. And I will see you next time.